Welcome to The Prime Directive. I'm Jeffico and this is Chris. Say hi, Chris.
Hey.
We're going to run through the top 10 trick Halloween episodes for you.
So set your phasers to spooky. We're going in.
Starting off at number 10, Cat's Paw of the original series. Chris, what's your take on that?
Easily the weakest episode we have on this list, but also the most Halloween-y. Kirk and crew beam down to a planet where they find themselves being warned off a castle in the distance by a group of three ethereal witches. Of course, they proceed anyway and wake up to find themselves chained to the wall of a dungeon surrounded by spooky, scary skeletons. This episode involves a giant cat, magical powers, and explicit references to trick-or-treating, making it basically the original series version of a Halloween special. Overall, a terrible episode, but I don't see how we could have a Halloween list without mentioning it.
No, it is necessary. Moving on to number 9, The Haunting of Deck 12, our Star Trek Voyager episode. Chris, I'll leave this entirely in your hands.
You're not a Voyager fan, are you?
It had its moments.
Okay. Well, similar to the last episode, this is not the strongest piece of Star Trek that's ever come out, but the theme is perfectly in keeping with what we're trying to do here. Neelix begins this episode by telling a ghost story to the four Borg children to keep them occupied during a power outage on Voyager. The story he tells is of Voyager picking up an entity from a nebula through the Bessard collectors. This entity starts wreaking havoc with the systems on Voyager and injuring crew members before Captain Janeway realizes that she has to get it back into the nebula and out of her ship. Now, the whole time we're doing this, we have to wonder how much of what we're hearing is even real. After all, this is just Neelix telling the story to a bunch of kids. And of the things that are real, how much of this is Neelix exaggerating? Because he's Neelix. In the end, the Borg children end up poking a lot of plot holes in his story. But the very ending of the show implies that it was all true, which I feel is really a bit of a cop-out on the writer's part there. Still, ghost story episode, very creepy. I think it deserves our number 9. On to number 8, Impulse from Star Trek Enterprise. Jeff, your thoughts?
The NX Enterprise finds a drifting Vulcan cruiser inside an asteroid field. The Vulcans are mining Trellian ore, a mineral that can insulate a ship against spatial anomalies in the expanse. But it's also a deadly neurotoxin to Vulcans. Turns them into zombies. The investigating away team is faced with T'Pol going insane.
Let me out!
The ship's about to blow. Get the hell out of here.
So, Chris, this was clearly the finest episode of Star Trek Enterprise. What were your thoughts on it?
Didn't stand out much as an episode, but I'm digging the zombie theme. Coming in at number 7, Wolf in the Fold from Star Trek The Original Series.
So Scotty gets a concussion because a female crew member made a mistake with the ship. So they all decide to go down to the planet and take in some belly dancers. You can actually see Kirk turn off his sexual magnetism so Scotty can get the girl. Later we find out that the girl's killed and everybody thinks it's Scotty because he hit his head and can't remember. A few more deaths occur and then they all go up to the Enterprise to try and figure out what's actually going on. And what is actually going on? The entity, known as Jack the Ripper, seems to be able to transfer himself from host to host, planet to planet, and is actually the culprit behind it all. It was a creepy episode, and it brought in a little mythology of Jack the Ripper, which was nice. Chris, do you remember that episode?
I do. This one loses a lot of points for the first 5 minutes, which is possibly the most sexist 5 minutes of Star Trek ever put to film, and that is saying something for the original series.
There's a lot.
Yeah. Number 6 on our list of Halloween episodes, Star Trek TNG's Night Terrors.
Everyone aboard a Federation starship is dead, and they had killed each other, and the Enterprise is there to solve this mystery. But then the crew starts hallucinating. Worf starts trying to kill himself, Picard's having a freak out in the turbolift, Beverly sees dead bodies rise. And Troy? Well, she floats in some sort of dreamlike space, talking to some other telepath who refuses to talk to her in the normal world. It's probably the only painful part of that episode. Chris, what were your thoughts?
Yeah, the scariest part of this episode is probably having to watch Troy float around in her onesie. I really wish they'd gotten some better angles or maybe something nicer for her to wear for those scenes.
Yeah. Moving on to number 5, where I was voted out of having an episode from the animated series because none of them were scary. Barge of the Dead, Star Trek Voyager. Chris, what's your take on this one?
Alright, this is the one where B'Elanna goes to Klingon Hell. B'Elanna dies and is then revived after a shuttle accident, but while dead, she experiences visions of Grethor, or Klingon Hell. Just before being revived, she sees her mother on the Barge of the Dead with her, and this makes her want to go back. Janeway is initially skeptical, but eventually allows the Doctor to bring B'Elanna very close to death, so she can go back to Grethor and try and rescue her mother. This episode is chock full of horrific imagery. The deaths of many Voyager crew members, flames, pain, souls jumping off the Barge of the Dead into oblivion, and is overall a pretty good episode. I think it deserves our number 5. Coming in at number 4, our first Star Trek DS9 episode, Impok Nor. Jeff, tell me about that one.
Well, DS9 was the greatest series, and it had about 3 or 4 scary episodes, but this is definitely one of the best ones. The station is in need of Cardassian parts, so naturally, they go off to Impok Nor, the sister station, left randomly in space. Full of Cardassian traps, O'Brien, Nog, Garak, and 4 other Starfleet officers scour this creepy station. Their shuttle blows up, Cardassians come out of stasis and hunt them. Garak manages to turn the tables on them, but is just as affected by a psychotropic drug that turned them insane.
He asked me to get a coil spanner for him. I just turned my back for a second.
It's a shame. And the worst part of it is, this isn't a coil spanner. It's a flux coupler.
In the end, Impok Nor was probably one of the best scary episodes of DS9. Moving into the top 3, somehow, The Thaw. Chris, your take on this one? Entirely you?
Well, that sounds like a Voyager episode to me. I had to fight to get this one on the list. I think it's perfect. This episode is the one where Janeway and crew discover 4 people stored in cryogenic tubes on a planet below. These people are still having experiences while their bodies are frozen, thanks to their consciousness being uploaded to a computer program. Upon finding that they're unable to wake any of the people in the pods, Kim and Torres upload their own consciousnesses into the program. Once inside, they find that the subconscious fears of the people in the program have coalesced into a scary clown that has the ability to kill them with fear if they don't do what he wants. This episode features strange and disturbing imagery from inside the Dream Clown's domain, as well as a wonderful speech at the end from Captain Janeway on how fear exists to be conquered. There, that's my take on it.
You lost me at Dream Clown. Moving on to one of my favorite episodes of Star Trek The Next Generation, Conspiracy. Chris, what are your thoughts on it?
Alright, I think that most of the creep from this episode happens right at the beginning, but boy is it good. We get lots of unsettling vibes from the music, the camera direction, the lighting, and all of this sneaking around that Picard and the Enterprise have to do to covertly meet up with all the other captains. And then still, the audience and the Enterprise is unsure of what's really going on. We get to see the destruction of another one of the captain's ships.
And watch your back, Picard.
Even Riker play-acts us to trick us into believing he's been taken over by these symbiotic creatures.
Come, have a look.
I think I'll summon my science officer.
It won't like your science officer. It does like you.
It also has the most gruesome death, as Commander Remick gets phaser blast to the face.
No, well,
you don't understand.
We seek peaceful coexistence.
Thank you. Moving on to our number one, top choice.
I have no problem getting to sleep, and then I think I'm sleeping all night. When I wake up, I feel exhausted.
How long has this been going on?
2-3 days. Do you have to hold that thing that close? I'm sorry. I've been on edge all day.
Oh, man. This is an excellent episode, even disregarding the Halloween list. Riker can't get any sleep, Worf's afraid of scissors, and random bridge ensign has PTSD from flat surfaces. The creepiness of the episode culminates in the scene in the holodeck, where the four affected characters are rebuilding the room in which they've been experimented upon and dissected.
Computer, there were noises coming from the darkness. Strange.
Clicking sounds.
I've been in this room before.
We've all been here before.
Your arm has been amputated and surgically reattached.
Ensign Rager and I were lucky to have escaped. Lieutenant Hagler's dead. Whoever it was sent that thing was more than simply curious.
All right, that's our top 10. Let's throw out some honorable mentions here. Moving on to Equinox, part 1 and 2. Chris?
Mostly this episode is just for the scene with the Doctor operating on 7 of 9 while making her sing My Darling Clementine. That scene has always creeped me out.
Yeah, and Equinox, interdimensional fish creatures killing people by sucking life out of them, and who can't forget the poor man's holodeck. The episode pitted Captain against Captain, both with different moral views. Probably my favorite episode of Voyager on this list that we've done today.
Next on the honorable mention list, Genesis from Star Trek TNG.
We've analyzed the venom and compared it to the acidic compound found at Junction 17 and on Decks 10 and 12. They all have the same enzymatic composition.
You're saying that Worf is spraying this...
venom.
This venom all over the ship?
I'd say so.
The Enterprise appears to be adrift.
Main power is offline. All systems are in standby or emergency mode. Her genetic codes are being resequenced, and her cells are mutating as a result. His upper spinal column has been broken in 3 places.
Looks as though he's been attacked by an animal.
Will, can you understand what it is that I... Deck 17. Deck 17.
Next is Distant Voices. Bashir fearing what all humans fear, turning 30. He gets attacked by a Lethian who uses his electrical charge from his hand to incapacitate the Doctor. Bashir tries making sense of this, but nothing around him is working. All his friends are acting strangely. It's not until he realizes it's all inside his head. Then he starts to figure it out, fight it, and come out of his coma. And the one episode that I really wanted in our top 10, but Chris was entirely against.
Absolutely not.
Sub Rosa.
Nope.
The TNG episode where Beverly's grandmother dies, and they go to this Federation-like planet. She has to go to
Scotland.
Yeah, Planet Scotland, that's what it was. And she goes to the funeral. And then she sees something. Something off in the distance. A handsome man named Ronan.
There wasn't another person in my dream. It was more like a presence.
You said you felt a touch.
A pair of hands. They were moving across my skin.
Like a caress?
Yes. And there was a voice, a man. He whispered my name. It was as if I knew him. Or more like he knew me. He knew exactly how I liked to be touched. It was the most physical dream I've ever had.
We're giving this too much airtime.
This is going to get the most airtime ever.
Oh.
Ronan is this glorious Fabio-like man.
What's happening?
I love you, Beverly. Just as I loved Felisa before you.
You're telling me that you're an 800-year-old ghost?
What the hell is going on?
It's not easy for me to take corporeal form. I can't do it for long. I want you to light the candle.
Beverly, what the hell is this?
A lot of bad Star Trek episodes are so bad they're good. This one is just bad.
I 100% disagree. The grandmother comes alive. Data and Geordi dig her up, which isn't disrespectful at all. And she comes alive because the ghost has possessed her and attacks them.
Beverly, it's all right. Have trust in me.
You're not Nana. Nana's dead. Leave her alone! You have been using me, Nana, my entire family, for centuries!
And I loved all of them! And they loved me!
Her entire family, Jeff.
Well, thank you for joining us in our top 10 Star Trek Halloween episodes. If you have any episodes we missed, comment below or contact us at JefficoFilms on Twitter.
I love you.
God, I hate this episode so much, Jeff.
It's amazing.